congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Thoroughly and truly enjoyed the film.
Oh, thank you.
I need to ask though, because Suzanne has gone on and praised you for making such a faithful adaptation.
Yes.
It must have taken some of the pressure off, but how do you react to that? And how about the fans? You have legions and legions of fans to please. How does one prepare for that?
Well, I mean, I don't think you can worry about the fans. Mm-hmm. I shouldn't say that. That's a terrible thing to say. Forget I said that.
Don't mind.
Yeah. I don't think you can worry about whether you're displeasing or pleasing someone, mm-hmm. because you haven't met them. Yes. And it's just your own anxiety and your own imagination. There would be no way to know if you can or not. I mean, I was a fan before I was anything else. I loved the book.
All three of them?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And so, you know, when I read, especially when I read the first book, I just was dying to do it. I closed the cover and said, I have to go do this. And so that felt to me just completely organic. And then if I'm pleasing myself as a fan and if I'm pleasing Suzanne as an author, I have to believe that I'm doing a faithful adaptation. I know that we have. So I think they'll be pleased.
I noticed, though, that you, because obviously, as we all know, with books to film translations, something's got to give.
Okay.
Something's got to give. And you've made a couple of choices and quite apparent choices to leave certain story, well, not arcs, but storylines out. Can you talk more about how you came to those choices?
We haven't really left many out. I mean, the Avox subplot, mm-hmm. you know, was a shame because I really loved that and I would have loved to include
exactly,
it.
Exactly, yeah.
More to the point, we've included certain things, like we've included, the Game
Rose
Center,
Garden.
The Rose Garden, yeah. but also the Game Center and stuff like that. What was in Cat, but that's just a translation from one medium to the other, because in Katniss's mind, she imagines what the game makers must be doing to her, right?
Right.
At this moment. And I can't film inside her mind the way Suzanne can, but I can cut away to the Game Center. Mm-hmm. So she and I are both doing the same thing. Katniss, Suzanne, by examining Katniss's inner monologue, me by being able to cut to the place that Katniss is imagining. So it really is just a question of translating one medium to the other.
Right. I'm sure you've heard this before, but a lot of fans, a lot of cult fans as well, are up in arms about, Battle Royale fans.
Yes, of
course. Are you familiar with the Japanese book?
I've never seen Battle Royale on purpose.
Okay. Because,
yeah.
Right.
I didn't know about it till I began this. And then when I began this, I thought, you know what? I better not see that movie. I don't want to be influenced by
course,
it unconsciously.
Yes.
And so I just avoided it on purpose because I felt it was just a wiser thing to do under
right.
the circumstances.
Have you seen it since?
No, I don't really plan to, at least until the movie's out.
Good idea.
Yeah,
good
because
idea.
I think it's better to keep hermetically sealed than to be able to say, you know what, I've never seen this movie, and also that I just came from a purer place.
That's true. But yeah. I'm sure you've read all the sort of buzz
sure.
along online. What are your thoughts about people being all up in arms about, you know, because obviously the concept itself is as old as time, really. I mean, harken back to the Romans.
Sure.
And it was
exactly, yeah,
history.
Yeah, gladiatorial yeah. arena, exactly. Yes. That's what Suzanne took it from. I mean, you know, the Roman arena lasted 900 years, so I think it predated Battle Royale. But,
yeah.
You know, I don't really look at I think if this was, people were really that up in arms, the series wouldn't have sold 27 million copies so far.
I exactly.
Mean,
Would you encourage the Battle Royale fans to go and take in Hunger Games?
Sure, absolutely. And I promise if they do, I'll go see Battle Royale when all this is over.
There you go.
Okay.
What else, what do you think when people say, oh, but then it's also, you know, it's Battle Royale meets The Running Man, meets The Lord of the Flies, meets
well, you know,
Truman
I,
Show?
Like, I've done this in every movie I've done. When I did Big, which was my first movie, right?
Yes.
You know, we had Vice Versa, like Father Like Son, 18 Again, Summer Switch.
I love how you can just turn
subsequently had Jack. Well, it was my world then, and I was all worried about it, but it didn't really matter. I mean, Big kind of endures as its own movie, and we did our thing, and everything worked out fine, you know? And those were really, when I did Dave, there was also Moon Over Parador, and everybody was up in arms about that, but there would also have been Prisoner of Zenda and The Prince and the Pauper and a lot of other things like it. When I did Pleasantville, it was the same year there was The Truman Show,
exactly.
and I had the bad fortune of coming out second, so... But it was.
But Pleasantville was a brilliant movie.
Yeah,
it stood on its own. And Hunger Games
and endures today.
Yeah.
You know, Seabiscuit. There was no other horse. Although I guess I guess Secretariat has come subsequently. And I think that Hunger. I think I made a really good movie.
Right.
I mean, I really
you
do.
Did too. How important do you think this movie is in this place in history, in this place in time, and for the young people? What do you think people should take away?
Oh, I think
this?
It's important. I do. I mean, I think that it's. I think it says a lot about where we are as a culture. I think it talks about the way entertainment can be used as a political instrument as the culture coarsens and devolves potentially. Mm-hmm. You know, give them bread and circuses. That's what happened in ancient Rome, and this is the circus. And so, and I think the biggest thing that's resonant is, in a world where you're made to fight for your own survival and pit it against one another, Katniss refuses to play that game, and she finds a way to discover and preserve her own humanity instead of succumbing to the system of the state by participating in their spectacle. Mm-hmm. And I think how many cultures would be better off if people didn't succumb to the will of the state that way, but found their own individual strength.
And their independence.
And their independence and their individuality and preserve their own humanity.
Yeah.
Right? And so I think that's resonant to everyone.
Okay, thank you so much.
Of course, thank
May
you.
May the odds always
be in my favor.
Well, I don't think you